I'd like to express my sincere gratitude for the invitation of the host country, Her Excellency Siti Nurbaya Bakar, Minister of Environment and Forestry, Republic of Indonesia, and to the Honourable Josh Frydenberg, Australian Minister for the Environment and Energy, to deliver our country's statement at the 3rd Asia-Pacific Rainforest Summit here in Yogyakarta, Indonesia. Our theme for this summit, Protecting Forests and People, Supporting Economic Growth, is very much in time and significant in our recent initiatives in Brunei Darussalam. As we hosted the 2nd Asia-Pacific Rainforest Summit in 2016 in Brunei Darussalam, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the Australian Government and the Center for International Forestry Research for all the support in making the summit a very successful event. During the summit, we acknowledged the significant role of the government institutions in promoting effective governance of our rainforests. We also recognized the essential role of the forest industries in bringing back investment into the forestry sector, finance forestry projects and programs, and contribute to sustainable development. We also agreed that rainforest sector restoration and management is not the sole responsibility of the government, but as a whole, we must act and share together the responsibility of conserving our rainforest ecosystem. Ladies and gentlemen, Brunei Darussalam is a relatively small country, yet we have gained recognition for having a well-kept tropical rainforest, of which majority is still in pristine condition. At present, 41% of the country's land area is declared as forest reserves and are protected by legislation. The country's forestry sector was formalized with the passage of the Forest Act in 1934, some 80 years ago. It paved the way for the proclamation of the national forest, and by adopting the principle of renewability, sustainability, multiple use, and ecological equilibrium management strategies and programs, we sustainably manage and administer our forests. At present, I'm proud to announce that our forest reserves are still 100% covered with forests. Ladies and gentlemen, in respect of our intended nationally determined contribution, INDC, our forests play an important role in mitigating our emission. Brunei's tree cover is estimated to be 72.1% of the total land area of 5,765 square kilometers. It comprises of what experts believe to be the oldest tropical rainforest in the world, to include mangroves and peat swamps, which sequester carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. As a contribution to our INDC, the government of Brunei Darussalam intends to increase the total gazetted forest reserves to 55% of the country's total land area. Currently, our gazetted forest reserves is 41% of the country's land area and are protected by the Forest Act. Our protected forest has made Brunei on the top 7 countries globally with forest land under protected status, according to the World Bank report. In addition to our forestry commitments to INDC, the timber utilization quota remains at 100,000 cubic meters per year and is strictly implemented. Our timber production statistics in the past years has always been below the required logging quota. Instead, we have been promoting the effective and efficient utilization and processing of timber through the use of high technologies and modern woodworking machineries. Ladies and gentlemen, peat swarm forests are the second most dominant forest type in Brunei Darussalam, covering 16% of the country's land area. They are very much intact and believed to be the highest proportion of intact peat swarm ecosystem in Southeast Asia. Our peat swarm forests played a significant role during our early economic development as it supports the raw material needs of the early structural development of our oil and gas sector and its related infrastructure. However, the realization of the true protective and biological value of the peat swarm ecosystems has prompted the government to preserve the forest and finally end the exploitation of this forest ecosystem. Peat swarm forests have more benefits in terms of its rich biological diversity. As such, the sequestration of the massive carbon deposits of our peat swarm ecosystem, as well as in our natural forests, will be our great contribution to the global climate change initiatives. At present, we are opening our windows for more research collaborations in further understanding the ecosystem and to develop effective management strategies for the benefits of the global communities. Ladies and gentlemen, the Brunei government has steadily opened up its economy and called for partnership with stakeholders in the private sector to take advantage of the opportunities offered by the diversification as outlined in the Brunei Vision 2035. At present, the development of sustainable ecotourism and the conservation of biodiversity become part of our environment strategy as continuing efforts of the government to conserve our remarkable biodiversity, rainforests, and natural habitats. It stresses the development of our rainforest resources, conservation and protection, and sustainable ecotourism as the main focus of the forestry sector. The increasing national appreciation on forest conservation and the value of its biodiversity have led to another approach in forest management and administration. This increasing value has led us to the development of the non-extractive economic activities such as sustainable ecotourism that would benefit the country, especially the local communities adjacent to our forest ecosystem. Sustainable ecotourism would promote responsible and committed tourism through their participation in forest conservation initiatives. Also in tree planting, culture and heritage protection, and the provision of alternative livelihood to local communities. However, to realize sustainable ecotourism, our conservative society needs more entrepreneurial and creative minds from the private sector to develop our ecotourism industry. At present, we are reassessing our ecotourism potential and identifying potential partners that will strengthen local community management skills in providing the necessary ecotourism and cultural services. Ladies and gentlemen, going back to our theme, protecting forests and people, supporting economic growth, is not only a national concern, but of a global issue. Brunei is relatively a small country that makes it looks manageable, but of course, we cannot do it alone. The issues at hand require a regional and or global approach and come up with better ideas, policies, action plans, and implementation strategies. These ideas and policies shall be translated into courses of actions for implementation, which will definitely require experts, knowledge, infrastructure, as well as substantive financial and technical assistance from potential partners, donors, and developed nations. I would say that this venue, the Asia Pacific Rainforest Summit, is the most ideal place to generate such collaborations in meeting our shared and common objectives. I'm very positive that the political will embedded in these collaborations and with our driving force to protect our rainforests and at the same time support our national economic initiatives, these initiatives can be a reality. In closing, I wish us all a productive conference and learn a lot from the discussion as we bring back these constructive ideas to our home countries. Wabillahi taufiq wa hidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you.